criminal justice reform. But when I go home to South Carolina this weekend, trust me when I tell you, no one is going to ask me about any of those issues. They're going to ask me, what in the hell is going on with the Department of Justice and the FBI? The reason we have special counsel, this is a very important point, and you know it, the reason we have special counsel is because of a conflict of interest. The regulation itself specifically makes reference to a conflict of interest. And we don't like conflicts of interest because it undercuts people's confidence in both the process and the result. So let's be really clear why we have special counsel. There was either a real or perceived conflict of interest that we were fearful would either impact the result or people's confidence in the process. That's why we have something called special counsel, and that's why we have special counsel in this fact pattern. And then, lo and behold, those who are supposed to make sure there are no conflicts of interest seem to have a few of their own. There's a senior prosecutor who sent obsequious emails to a fact witness. She can be described as nothing other than a fact witness. She's a really important fact witness if you pursue the line of inquiry that my Democrat friends want to pursue. They got off of collusion, and now they're on obstruction of justice. She may be the most important fact witness in an obstruction of justice case. And the senior prosecutor for this conflict of interest-free special counsel sent a fawning, obsequious email to a fact witness. And then we have prosecutors assigned to conduct this investigation who donated almost exclusively to one candidate over another. And then we have a prosecutor assigned to this conflict of interest-free team that attended what was supposed to be, what he'd hoped to be, a victory party for Secretary Clinton. And we have a senior DOJ official, Mr. Deputy Attorney General, with an office that used to be two doors down from yours, meeting with Fusion GPS, and Fusion GPS, of course, was paying for Russian dirt on the very person that they're supposed to be objectively investigating. And then that same senior DOJ official's wife, the one that met with Fusion GPS, his wife was on the payroll of Fusion GPS. And then we have a senior agent assigned to investigate Secretary Clinton's email, help draft the exoneration letter, where we changed the language from grossly negligent to extremely careless, interviewed Secretary Clinton in an interview I've never seen, and I doubt you have either in your career as a prosecutor, interviewed Michael Flynn, was actively involved in the investigation into the Trump campaign before the Inspector General found his text. So this agent, in the middle of almost everything related to Secretary Clinton and President Trump, sent pro-Clinton texts, anti-Trump texts to his paramour in response to being told maybe he is where he is to protect the country from that menace, Donald Trump. He said, I can protect our country at many levels. And then he said Hillary Clinton should win 100 million to nothing. Now think about that, Mr. Deputy Attorney General. That's a pretty overwhelming victory. 100 million to zero. And when I read that last night, what I thought was this conflict of interest-free senior agent of the FBI can't think of a single solitary American who would vote for Donald Trump. That's where the zero comes in. Not a single solitary American he can imagine would vote for Donald Trump. This is the conflict of interest free special agent assigned. And then he went on, if that weren't enough, to belittle Trump supporters by saying he could smell them at a Walmart in Virginia. This is the person we needed to avoid a conflict of interest. And then he said this, they fully deserve to go and demonstrate the absolute bigoted nonsense of Trump. But he wasn't content to just disparage Donald Trump. He had to disparage Donald Trump's family. This is what he said, Mr. Deputy Attorney General. He said, the douchebags are about to come out. He's talking about our First Lady and children, this conflict of interest-free special agent of the FBI. This is who we were told we needed to have an objective, impartial, fair, conflict of interest-free investigation. So he's openly pulling for the candidate he had a role in clearing. and he's openly investigating a candidate that he has bias against. And then if that's not enough, he says Trump is an effing idiot. What the F just happened to our country? This is the same man that said he would save our country. What happens when people who are supposed to cure the conflict of interest have even greater conflicts of interest than those they replace? That's not a rhetorical question. You nor I nor anyone else would ever sit Peter Strzok on a jury. We wouldn't have him objectively, dispassionately investigate anything, knowing what we know now. Why didn't we know it ahead of time? And my last question, my final question to you, and I appreciate the chairman's patience, how would you help me answer that question when I go back to South Carolina this weekend?
Congressman, first of all, with regard to the special counsel, Mr. Strzok was already working on the investigation when the special counsel was appointed. The appointment that I made was of Robert Mueller. So what I'd recommend that you tell your constituents is that Robert Mueller and Rod Rosenstein and Chris Wray are accountable, and that we will ensure that no bias is reflected in any of the actions taken by the special counsel or in any matter within the jurisdiction of the Department of Justice. When we have evidence of any inappropriate conduct, we're going to take action on it. And that's what Mr. Mueller did here. As soon as he learned about this issue, he took action. And that's what I anticipate that the rest of our prosecutors, our new group of U.S. attorneys, our Justice Department appointees, they understand the rules and they understand the responsibility to defend the integrity of the department. And if they find evidence of improper conduct, they're going to take action. So, Congressman, that's the best assurance I can give you. But actually, there's one other point, which is you should tell your constituents that we exposed this issue because we're ensuring that the Inspector General conducts a thorough and effective investigation. And if there is any evidence of impropriety, he's going to surface it and report about it publicly.
I'll try.